Most people see natural selection as the main engine of evolution. This supposedly slow and gradual mechanism drives changes in the way species look and behave over time. It's also commonly called survival of the fittest, but that's a little confusing because it's not always the biggest and the strongest who survive. In reality, natural selection is all about reproduction. The organism that had the most descendants in later generations was, by definition, the fittest, and that usually comes about because some variation in an organism helped it to be more suited to its environment than others.
Everybody talks about natural selection, and they kind of almost imagine like it's a magic wand, it's an explanation for everything. Natural selection is simply differential reproduction. In all living systems, in all population, some individuals reproduce more than others. That is natural selection.
As an example from my work in soil microbiology, particularly with pesticide degradation, if we add pesticide to a soil system to kill weeds, insects, or diseases, within that bacterial population, there is a portion that can degrade or utilize that pesticide as a carbon or nitrogen source to grow. So that over time, you had a change in this population, but natural selection did not bring about any new features. It was already in the population.
The first time that I saw a creation presentation on natural selection, I was just amazed at my blindness prior to that in not realizing that natural selection can only operate on whatever is existing, and it can only operate to remove what is existing. And so the realization that it doesn't actually produce new genetic information was an absolute bombshell to me.